Pat Thompson, 6'1", junior from Huntington Beach, California. Number two, Kendra Kells. As defensive specialist, 5'7", junior from Honolulu. Number four, Claire Marie Anderson. And center, 5'9", senior from Honolulu. Floor captain, number seven, Taylor Higgins. And outside hitter, 6'2", freshman from Lafayette, California. Number nine, Kirsten Sibley. And Lee Barrow, 5'8", junior from Kalihi, Oahu. Number 15, Savannah Kaka. And middle hitter, 6'3", sophomore from Oceanside, California. Number 17, Casey Castillo. And that middle hitter, 6'3", junior from Coquitlam, British Columbia, Canada. Number 19, Emily Maglio. The Hawaii Staff Director of Operations, Cleo Baxter. Volunteer Assistant, Tom Pestalacci. Assistant, Lindsay Berg. Associate Head Coach, Jeff Hall. Head Coach for your Rainbow Wahine, Dave Shoji.
You're watching OC Sports, your home for University of Hawaii sports.
Number 42 for head coach Dave Shoji comes with lofty expectations. The sixth-ranked Rainbow Wahine returned 12 letter winners from a team that made it to the Elite Eight a year ago. But alas, injuries in the run-up to tonight's momentous season opener has forced the Hawaii coaching staff to make creative changes to the lineup. Tonight, it's Big Ten versus Big West, the fourth-ranked Wisconsin Badgers and the sixth-ranked Hawaii Rainbow Wahine. Rainbow Wahine Volleyball is back for the 2016 season. The Hawaiian Tel FCU starting lineups will be scrolling in the bottom right corner of your screen. The Rainbow Wahine, ranked sixth in the ABCA preseason poll, playing host to the Wisconsin Badgers, number four, their highest preseason ranking in program history. A new look coaching staff for Hawaii. A lot of new faces that would otherwise not be out there here tonight due to injuries to key players and returnees. We don't really necessarily know what we're going to get tonight from Hawaii, Chris.
I mean, we know for sure we'll see new faces and new lineups, and I believe we'll see Emily Maglio hitting out of the back row.
Warren Carlini gets the serving started. Here's Emily Maglio hitting out of the front row. That's dug up. Left side set goes to Lauren Gillis, and Hawaii able to keep it alive. So Taylor Higgins goes outside to the newcomer, the freshman, Kirsten Sibley. Little rat-a-tat near the net. Wisconsin with it again. Gillis, a second time. Sibley plays it off the ricochet. Middle set, Maglio block. Right there is Kahakai. How about this rally to start this match? Right side, that's Romana Krishkova, and she's able to put it down for the opening point.
Rainbow Wahine Volleyball is back. Classic long rally for the Rainbow Wahine, playing some great defense. Kahakai with one great dig and one great cover to keep that rally alive.
A little runner serve by Carlini, and that one falls off the table. That was nasty. And it's an ace and a point for Wisconsin. They're up two, serving zero.
Carlini coming off some international experience this summer, having played in the Pan Am Cup, where she was the starting center. That's like the second national team.
Another tough serve. Claire Marie Anderson with the pass. Sibley, make that tough. Kendra Kelsch from the opposite position going down the line. Kendra Kelsch, the former setter, taking over basically for where Nikki Taylor would be. Taylor out with the left elbow injury, and it's Kendra Kelsch getting Hawaii off the schneid.
Kelsch will head out of the front row, but the back row attacking, I think, is going to come from Maglio mostly.
And there's Maglio trying to dig up that swing, but Krishkova able to put it down, and it's another Wisconsin point. Kanoa Leahy, Chris McLaughlin here courtside. The officiating crew tonight, Wayne Lee up top, Dixon Chun down on the court, and the line judges, Darren Chun and Wesley Kawachi. And that serve goes into the net. With Sarah Dodd coming in, 5-4 freshman. So two serving three, and Kelsch back behind the line to serve. 6-1 junior from Huntington Beach, California.
Maglio sat out for one play. Now she's back in the back row. She looked terrific the last 2 days hitting out of the back row.
Middle set, big swing by Haley Nelson, and that will pay off with another point. Haley Nelson is a good one, a 2015 AVCA second-team All-American, getting the set from Lauren Carlini, a two-time first-team All-American. This Wisconsin squad is stacked. Served by Nelson, passed by Anderson. Here's Sibley from off the net, and that one goes into the twine. You imagine a little bit of nerves from the freshman, Kirsten Sibley, from Lafayette, California.
No question she's got some nerves, but watch her, once she relaxes, she's got one live arm. Love watching her play this week.
Nelson, another float serve. Anderson the pass. Higgs goes back row to Maglio, just knuckles it over, so a chance here for the Badgers. Out of the back row, the swing by Gillis, but the wall was up. And it was Casey Castillo in the middle.
I think Sibley also helped with that one, but yeah, you're right. I think Castillo did get most of that. She's now played on the left, she's played on the right, and now she's played in the middle. Miss Versatility, we'll call her.
The Swiss Army knife for this Rainbow Wahine volleyball team. But we count up the injured players. Nikki Taylor, All-American with the left elbow injury. Annie Mitchum out for some time with a left pinky that she broke in training camp.
And Clay Greeley still nursing the shoulder that got had surgery on last January. Still not quite the pop she'd like to have on her swings, but she can play the back row, and that's what she's doing right now for Kendra Kelsch.
As one of the more capable passers, certainly, for this Hawaii team.
Exactly.
Amber McDonald to serve. Kahakai in the middle of the floor, bumps it in the air. Here's Maglio from the back row. And that one tickles the back line for a Hawaii point.
You know, I think I would give Emily Maglio most improved from last year to this year, mostly because she played on the beach this last year, made beach All-American, and just improved her hitting skills, her defensive skills, and even her passing skills.
Here's another newcomer to the bunch, Emma Smith, 5'8 freshman from Manhattan Beach, California. Haggerty goes off the high hands of the block, but a net violation called against the Rainbow Wahine.
Maglio got a little bit aggressive there, caught the cable on her follow-through on the block. Check the net cam here, watch Maglio in the middle, see if she presses over. Oh, so there she caught her elbow on it. That was a little ticky-tack. That wasn't even involved in the play. Oh, I don't know about that one.
Meanwhile, Molly Haggerty goes into the net. Now, it should be stated, we may see it play out here at some point tonight, that we are utilizing the challenge review system on an experimental basis here in this early season tournament for the Rainbow Wahine, as Gillis goes down the line and in. And basically that means that each side, the coaches, can challenge calls. Obviously specific calls, it has to either be an in-out call, a touch call, a net violation, or a foot foul.
Each coach gets three. It won't be like the Olympics where you get unlimited challenges. You get three only.
Outside, the swing by Gillis off the block, punched in the air by McDonald, and it falls to the Terraflex. So the roof is up.
What about McKenna Granato getting most of that block? Solid play by the sophomore.
And there the brothers showed you. Well, you have Kavika there in the shot. Eric was sitting around him somewhere just a few moments ago.
Taylor Sander right now is sitting next to him, another starter for the U.S. team that got the bronze in Rio.
Step out goes to Nelson, kept alive by Hawaii. Here's Sibley off the block. Right there's Maglio. So Higgs goes backside to Kelch. Kicks it over the net, and we play on. The swing by Carlini. Hawaii keeps it going. Here's Kelch. Blocked and roofed this time. Oh, but that was thrilling for a moment.
It was.
And if you get a kick that goes over the net to keep a sequence alive, that's automatic recognition. Fujitsu Air Conditioning, cool play of the match. How about the level-headedness of Kendra Kelch?
The block, the cover by Maglio and Higgins, and then nobody covering at the end on her final swing. Now when she covered herself, got it over.
Somebody call Michelle Nagamine. Let her know that Kelch has that kind of talent. High and away, set goes to Lauren Gillis off the block. Good save, Higgins. Great second touch by Savannah Kahakai, one of the very best in the land at the libero position. Middle set, meanwhile, goes to Haley Nelson in the 6'4 senior. Hits it out. It hit the top of the tape. The official saying it did not hit the block, and you see Kelly Sheffield actually asking his players if it went off the block, and he's going to challenge this.
First challenge of the night by Sheffield. I think the ball did not touch any blocker. I think it did just hit the tape. Take a look at it here. Looks like all taped to me.
So Dixon Jun, the downstairs official, the referee two, if you will take a look at the monitor here, the official scorers table. Now, as you mentioned, each coach gets three challenges apiece, and there is no penalty for using a challenge. There is no reward if the challenge comes back in your favor. It is purely three challenges per side.
Correct. Look at those hands by Carlini. She's 6'2". Three-time All-American. And there's the swing. It does not look like it hits Kelch's hands. This is a little better look at it right here. Again, that looks like it just catches Cable alone, but we will soon find out what the ruling is.
Adding a little drama to the fray here on opening night. You like the review idea?
I do if they do it quickly. I don't like it if it lasts too long.
And it will be reversed. They're going to say that it touched one of the Rainbow Wahine players, and so credit Kelly Sheffield, a little communication with his players on the floor, and it's a point for Wisconsin, 10-7-6.
You don't see much argument by Kendra Kelch there, so it must have touched her, otherwise she might have been a little bit more in a protest mood.
So the challenge review system looming here very early on in this season opening match. 10-6, and it'll be Lauren Carlini floating it deep. Backpedaling, the pass by Claire Marie Anderson. Maglio blocked. Right there is Sibley. She'll get the bump set from Kahakai. Goes high hands. Badgers keep it going. Outside, Gillis. Deep corner and in.
Gillis has got a live arm to be sure. Gatorade Player of the Year in Indiana, 2013.
And a five-point advantage here for the fourth-ranked team in the country out of the Big Ten. Welcome back. Let's take a look at the Kaiser Permanente keys to the match. Mr. McLaughlin.
Well, for Wisconsin, they are big Badgers, to say the least. They average over 6 feet in the front row almost every single rotation. And for Hawaii, make patchwork quilt lineup work. A lot of confusion the last couple days. The right moves were made by Jeff Hall, Dave Shoji, and company. But whether or not it's going to work or not is really will be a key to this match for Hawaii.
And a huge part of it is the serve-receive formation. You see, it is very oblong. It is very unique. And a second ace served up by Lauren Carlini. That time, though, it goes into the twine. You talk about squeezing players. Basically, in other words, hiding some of the less proficient passers on the Hawaii side.
You really want to have your best passers passing the most part of the court is the theory there.
Right side set. That's Gillis. Goes up over the block. She's looking pretty good.
Transfer from USC. Already played in the Pac-12. High school All-American. Fab 50. Gatorade Player of the Year in Indiana. Played on the same club team as Tiona Williams, the middle blocker for Wisconsin.
So Sarah Dodd comes in to serve. Anderson the pass, tight to the net. And it's going to be a point for Wisconsin. They're going to flag Taylor Higgins, essentially, for being a back row attacker. So things getting away from Hawaii here in this opening set. Again, without the services of All-American and reigning Big West Conference Player of the Year, Nikki Taylor. Annie Mitchum, also a senior middle. Out with that broken left pinky. Kendrick Kelch playing in place of Taylor. That one dug up. Here's Haggerty. Nice dig off the ricochet there by Anderson. Big swing from Sibley, and she puts it down. Kirsten Sibley, there is a lot of potential there.
Clearly is. They call her Sibs, and she's got really a live arm. This week in practice, time after time, she would end rallies with that powerful swing of hers. Loves that cross-court attack. Will go wide, but loves the cross-court more.
Haggerty. Molly Haggerty, a 6'1 freshman from Glen Ellyn, Illinois. Badgers coming off of a season where they went 26-7. They finished third in the Big Ten. Made it to the Sweet 16 before losing to Florida in five sets. That was a thriller match. Here's Maglio from the back row for Hawaii. Badgers in transition. Middle set, and there is the aforementioned Tiana Williams, but that one tightrope walks the twine, and it finds its way out for a Rainbow Wahine point. Hawaii, meanwhile, coming off of one of the great seasons that they've had here in recent history, 29-2 overall. They finished Big West Conference play 16-0, the 15th time Hawaii has gone undefeated in conference play. They made it all the way to the Elite Eight.
The best one-loss percentage in the entire NC2A at 93%. That's pretty good.
Great serve by Greeley, and it winds up an ace. Well, that right shoulder may not be 100%, but she was still able to put some wicked English on that serve.
She puts a nice little punch on it and floats it. It'll drop off. It'll take her, advantage of the wind currents in this Fan Sheriff Center.
You both can go, all right?
And she can locate it pretty well, too. The coaches give her a spot to hit. She's pretty good at hitting the spot they ask for.
10 serving 15. Floats it over again. The pass by Haggerty. She'll get the set on the outside, and the block was up late.
You're obviously picking on Haggerty because she's a freshman, but she is some kind of freshman. Four-time national club champion, four-time state champion, the number five in the senior class, two times Illinois Gatorade Player of the Year.
Pass by Greeley. High and away, set goes to McKenna Granado. That's dug up by Gillis. Outside, here's Haggerty again against a solo block and a net violation called against Higgs. Once more. So 17-10 here in the opening stanza. And the serve by Amber McDonald. Higgins sets up Granado. Big windup, uncoils, and a nice-looking dig by Gillis in the back row. Now Haggerty blocked and roped. Higgs with a little payback.
Higgins did a nice job of moving that block to the inside when she saw the set was dropping inside. And forehands across, and Higgins gets all of it.
So in comes Emma Smith once again to serve. Three-time indoor volleyball letter winner at MiraCosta High School. Four-time letter winner in beach volleyball. And once again, Molly Haggerty strikes. You mentioned her high school resume. Never ended a season in high school on a loss. Four state titles, four club championships.
Pretty amazing.
That one, though, sails long for a Hawaii point. Much needed point, mind you. Hawaii trailing by a half dozen. And Taylor Higgins, now a senior. Amazing to see the progression here over the seasons. Taylor Higgins, now one of the veterans on this team. And Wisconsin able to, in transition, find Tiana Williams on the slide for the kill. Your impressions of this Badgers squad so far here in the first set?
It's about what I expected. They run a lot of slides, that step-out maneuver to the antenna, so they spread the offense out, antenna to antenna, making them very difficult to defend.
Kelly Bates serves that one into the net. So some issues in the service department here for Wisconsin, helping Hawaii to hang around in this opening set. We'll see if they can put a run together. This is one of the servers for the Rainbow Wahine who can do that. Claire Marie Anderson played in all 31 matches last year, had 12 aces, had that run against TCU a couple of times. Remember, in the opening round of the NCAA tournament, she served 23 times in that match. Pass by Bates. Left side set to Gillis off the high hands. Right there is Higgins. So Kahakai has to bump set Kelsch. Two blockers up. She rolls it over. Dug up back to the net by Haggerty. Now Hawaii with it. Outside. Here's Sibley. Cross court and out.
Oh, she took a mighty swing, though. She was not leaving anything left in the tank there. I like the aggressive swing by the freshman to play tentative out there and find her. She'll find a spot on the bench. She plays aggressive. Coaches will keep believing in her.
Here's Lauren Carlini. Couple of aces already that time. Perfect pass, Kahakai. Middle set, Maglio. Dug up by Bates off the block. Right side, that's Krishkova. Great dig, Kahakai. Kelsch blocked. Right there's Maglio. Where does Higgs go here? She'll go to Kelsch. Again, the roll shot. This time works.
Well, for those who are interested in numbers right now, Hawaii's offense hitting 0-0-0. Four kills, four errors. As to be expected, Wisconsin hitting 423. Huge number. It's Kahakai with a great collapse dig there to keep the rally alive.
Good touch at the net there on the swing. Here's Kelsch again from the opposite position. Two-handed in the air by Carlini. Gillis dug up by Maglio in the back row. Higgins out to Sibley on the outside off the fingertips. Gillis, the dink, diving save, Kelsch, but to no avail. Point once again for the Badgers. But to see Emily Maglio, based off of the experience on the beach where she was a first-team ABCA All-American, laying out, doing some of the things that we're seeing her doing, I mean, this is not the Emily Maglio that we saw in the indoor season a year ago.
So much improvement for the young lady from Canada.
Sibley misses wide down the line, and that's another point for Wisconsin. And Dave Shoji is going to signal for a timeout. So the Badgers jumping all over the Rainbow Wahine in the opening set of the opening match.
Rainbow Wahine Volleyball on OC Sports is sponsored by Straub and Hawaii Honda Dealers.
Well, the Rainbow Wahine having a tough go of it here in the season opener. In the opening set, trailing Wisconsin by eight. The Badgers hitting 414 here in the first. Casey Castillo, that one tickles that back line. So a good timeout by Dave Shoji and a point for Hawaii out of that break. Rainbow Wahine, prior to that, hitting in the negative numbers. That flatlines them at triple zeros. And Kendra Kelsch will serve. That one does not get over the top of the tape. Again, a short-handed Rainbow Wahine squad, which is kind of a bummer because you don't get a top 10 matchup to open the season very often, and those are two of the key players, obviously, this season for the Rainbow Wahine. Relegated to just watching this one from the side for the time being. Kirsten Sibley, though, this is what some of these injuries can allow for some of these younger players to get in the mix and start building some experience points.
Exactly. That's basically the mindset players have right now is, okay, bad news that Mitchum's out, bad news Taylor's out, bad news, you know, Greeley's not full, you know, full tilt. But the good news is you got to get a lot of younger players are going to get some development here.
Here's the serve by Greeley. Overpass. Castillo wasn't ready. Bump set goes to Granado and she's roofed. Tiana Williams all over that one. A 2015 ABCA honorable mention All-American and a Big Ten all-freshman team member. And that time, Castillo caught off guard.
She really should have tapped it down and gotten the point there. Instead, you're right, she was definitely caught unawares.
So Aloha ball here in the first set for Wisconsin. Step out to Castillo. Timing not quite there, so advantage here for the Badgers. Step out goes to Williams. She puts it down and puts the finishing touches on a dominant opening set for the fourth-ranked team in the country. The Wisconsin Badgers taking that one 25-16. And it will be come-from-behind time for Dave Shoji's crew.
Rainbow Wahine Volleyball on OC Sports is sponsored by Bank of Hawaii, Kaiser Permanente, and Island Air.
Welcome back to the Stan Sheriff Center. Wisconsin up 1-0 here against the home team, Rainbow Wahine. Series record is sponsored by Aston Hotels and Resorts. And Hawaii leading, I should say Wisconsin leading the all-time series 2-1. The last meeting was one of the epic matchups in Hawaii volleyball history. It was December 10th, 2004. Took place in the NCAA tournament in the Green Bay Regionals, and you see the numbers there. I mean, that was just one of the all-time classics.
You know, Wisconsin's got, you know, 100% of their offense back. Hawaii's got like 18% of their offense back. But guess what? A newcomer is leading them in kills right now. Molly Haggerty, the freshman, somehow broke into the starting lineup. She's got 6 kills on shots like that. She hits over the block, she hit between the block, again over the block. This one here, she sneaks inside, gets a little fancy play set inside the block. She's got it all going on. Young lady from Glen Ellen, Illinois, number 5 recruit in the country.
The only loss for Wisconsin from that team last year that went 26-7, made it to the Sweet 16, was Taylor Morey, their libero. So as you mentioned, 100% of the kills and blocks returning this year for Wisconsin. Let's go inside the numbers presented by Heineken. And there it is, 100% of the blocks and kills returning for Wisconsin. This is a Badgers team that over the last 16 matches last year went 15-1.
You believe that? 15-1. So they've got momentum coming into this year. Even though they lost to Florida in the, you know, the round of 16, they still left that season on a definite hot streak, and they're carrying over with it right now.
11 returnees total for Wisconsin, including 6 returning starters, and we mentioned all of the injuries and issues for Hawaii. Let's not forget, they lost Olivia McGill and Taimana Olevau from a season ago. So they lost a considerable amount of their offense as well as their blocking to begin with, so, let alone now with Nikki Taylor and Annie Mitchum on the side.
So you got the team in red knows each other very well, 115-16. They're playing with basically the same players except for Haggerty. The team in white is getting to know each other.
They're wearing name tags.
Exactly.
So set 2 underway. Gianna Guinasso getting the serving going. Granato is dug up. Tight to the net. Little battle there. But the Badgers keep it alive. Outside, here's Gillis now off the high hands. So it'll be a bump set by Bates. Back to Gillis. Dug up by Guinasso. Tight to the net. Pinballed around and finally slammed home by Haley Nelson. Well, you are seeing a spirited effort, though, from this shorthanded Hawaii squad.
Dave shows you giving Baby G a chance to play. Gianna Guinasso.
Step out. Here's Mags. She now becomes, with the aforementioned injuries, the focal point of this Hawaii team and offense.
And guess what? Wisconsin's going to be paying a lot of attention to her as a result of that.
Taylor Higgins now will serve. Jump serve. And a slide put down easily by Haley Nelson. Well, it was a great initial touch by Haggerty, who's been doing a little bit of everything already. The freshman here in her debut for Wisconsin.
You know, Hawaii's been trying to pick on her, by the way. They're figuring, oh, she's the only freshman that broke into the lineup. Let's go pick on her. And instead, what's happening is Haggerty's answering the call and passing the ball pretty well.
Here's Kelsch hitting from the left side. That one dug up. Right side set goes to Krishkova off the block and out. Romana Krishkova. Red shirt senior from Slovakia, a transfer a couple years ago from VCU.
Got her degree in May from VCU, and now she's in grad school at University of Wisconsin. Played for the Slovakian junior and senior national team, so she's got a lot of international experience.
Overpass placed down easily by Nelson. And Wisconsin jumps out in front of Hawaii again here in the second set. Sarah Dodd. That one blasts past the end. So much expectation for this Hawaii team based off of the phenomenal season that they had last year, a season that saw them make a run to the Elite Eight, a cathartic victory in the NCAA tournament in the round of 16 over Penn State, a sweep, mind you, then losing to another Big Ten team, Minnesota, in the Elite Eight. And so much expectation based on what was coming back, and yet that has to be hedged here in the early portion of this season because of the circumstances. Middle set, that goes to Nelson. She does it again.
You gotta remember that Hawaii losing, you know, the Big West Player of the Year, first team All-American, Nikki Taylor. Just that one loss alone is tough. Throw in Annie Mitchum, who came into camp in her best shape ever in her life. She now touches like 10-5. And then Greeley is a huge factor on offense as well.
Right side, here's Krishkova, puts it down right in front of Claire Marie Anderson. Yeah, Annie Mitchum, if there's something to look forward to, obviously these players in Nikki Taylor and Annie Mitchum expected to return here, hopefully sooner rather than later, certainly for Dave Shoji's preference, as Maglio puts a thump into that one.
Great pass by Claire Marie Anderson that time.
When those players do come back, and particularly Annie Mitchum, you will see the difference in her physically from a season ago. She's ready to pounce.
Absolutely, she's ready. She actually does hit every single day in practice. She just gets off the court quickly so as not to run into anybody, letting hurt that pinky of hers that she had surgery on last Tuesday.
Higgins going right side. Here's Kelsch by the double block. Great dig by the libero Bates. Back row set. Gillis blocked but pumped up in the air by Castillo. Sibley roll shot right there again is Bates. Outside. Here's the Frosch. Haggerty. The rally keeps going. Little miscommunication there, so advantage for the Badgers. Bates bump set to Krishkova over the double block. Right there is Higgs. Anderson bump sets. Maglio from the back row over the triple block. Sends it long. No touch up front. And a point for Wisconsin.
Tough ball to hit there. Bump set coming across her body high on the 12-foot line. Not an easy shot.
For the latest information on UH Athletics, go to HawaiiAthletics.com for UH news, tickets, videos, and more. Also visit UH's Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube sites to follow your favorite teams and get current fan promotions. Scramble play for Hawaii on the service. Step out goes to Tiana Williams, and the sophomore from Fort Wayne, Indiana, once again making her presence felt.
Wants to play pro volleyball in Italy someday is one of her goals in life.
Last year as a freshman, led the team and ranked fourth in the Big Ten Conference in blocks per set. Kelsch, big swing. Dug up by Gillis. Here's Haggerty, blocked, kept alive by Bates. Big windup by Haggerty. Right there is Kahakai. Outside set, Sibley, dug up by Haggerty. And we keep going. Great rallies here in this match. Diving save, Anderson. Bump set by Higgins. Sibley against the double block. Right there is Bates. Step out to Williams, blocked, pancake save, but only for a moment by Amber McDonald. And finally, somebody stakes claim to that long sequence.
Kirsten Sibley got all that. She got the roof there. What a rally, though, as you said, Kanoa. These two teams in rallies like that look more evenly matched than the score has indicated so far.
4-7-8. And the dump try by Carlini misses the court wide. A rare mistake from this fantastic senior. And it's a point for the Rainbow Wahine.
Arguably the number one setter in the country.
Two-time Big Ten Conference Setter of the Year. Kahakai with the serve. Step out, that's Williams. She gobbled up that nectar left up there by Carlini. Head coach Kelly Sheffield describes Lauren Carlini as a tireless worker at that setter position. Says the thing about her is she's so good already, but she has the humility to allow herself to always be open to learning something new. Step out, here's Williams. No blockers up, but Kahakai had it covered. Mags from the back row had to roll it over. Advantage Badgers outside. Big swing by Gillis, dug up by Anderson. Bump set to Maglio from Higgins, blocked. Right there is Higgs. So Kahakai bump sets left side to Sibley from off the net. Right there is Bates. Back row, that's Haggerty. Putting a finishing touch on that rally.
What an addition Haggerty has been to this already really good volleyball team. You see why they're fourth ranked in the country. Four teams in the top 10 are from the Big Ten.
Returning to live action, Sibley sends it long, no touch up front, and it's another point for the Badgers. They open up a 6-point advantage here in the second set. 3-0 run here for Wisconsin. And Dave Shoji's going to challenge something. Perhaps thinking there was a touch there.
You know
that
what?
Swing by Sibley.
I'll tell you what, he wants to slow the game down, not use a timeout. So he's asking whether or not there was a touch in the block, I guess. And this can turn into a timeout for the team. The coach can't talk to the team during the timeout, but the players can talk to each other.
Dave Shoji, when I asked him, what do you think about the challenge review system, he says the exact same thing that you said. If we do it right,
yeah.
I like it. What does he mean by do it right?
I think he means, can we get in and out of the challenge, you know, review in a reasonable amount of time and not have it take forever. Here we see, I think, what they're looking at. It looks to me like that might have been a touch there. At least the fans are thinking it is.
We saw a reversal of a touch call or a non-touch call earlier in the match in the first set. And so Dave Shoji probably feeling pretty good as you see some of the new faces along the bench there for Hawaii on the coaching staff. The introduction of Tom Pestalozzi to the staff. How about the pickup of Lindsey Berg to replace Robin Amos Santos, who left the program after last season?
We'll replace one three-time Olympian with another three-time Olympian.
Not?
So a challenge score, if you're keeping tabs at home, is Kelly Sheffield won, Dave Shoji won.
Yes. And again, there is no benefit or punishment from using these challenges. It's just three challenges for each side. As you take a look at Eric Shoji, starting libero for Team USA.
Now,
right behind him, Kavika, and right to the our left of Eric is, of course, Mary.
Taylor Sander right next to Kavika. I believe there's a couple more Olympians.
They got like a half dozen of them here in the stands.
I think middle blocker, this former Wahine assistant coach, Charlie Brand right there on the right. And I believe, besides Taylor Sander, I believe I saw David Smith in the stands as well. He's a middle blocker.
And I thought I also saw Eric actually wearing the bronze medal when they were introduced between sets. Here we go. There you see some of the other players who are also in the mix. And there is, to the left of your screen, Eric showed you wearing the bronze medal. How cool is that?
Yeah, that bronze medal match was something else. Wow.
Having to come from behind against the reigning Olympic champions in Russia.
Go figure, how do you do that? Russia's really good, amazing legacy in that Russian volleyball program. And the U.S. just dug down deep, and then dug down some more.
Yeah. And a special moment certainly for Dave and Mary, and even daughter Colby was there in Rio. To be able to witness all of that. Very special. Outside, Gillis dug up by Kahakai. What a beautiful snag by Kahakai, but Granado then gets roofed. Carlini right next to Tiana Williams.
Wisconsin picks up block number three here. Carlini got all of that. At 6'2", she's an imposing figure on that right side. She's no slouch as far as a blocking center is concerned.
Granado, big swing off the block. Right there is Castillo. Back row set to Mags was a little low, dug up back over the net. Advantage here for Hawaii. Can they do something with it? Granado tried to go down the line. Maybe got a little too artistic with it. Missed wide for a Wisconsin point. The timeout taken by Dave Shoji. We'll take a break as well. Badgers have Hawaii doubled up in set two. Welcome back to the Stan Sheriff Center. Tonight's Jack Fact, one of the few, the very few, Wisconsin 2-1 all-time versus Hawaii. One of only four teams that have played Hawaii more than once and have a winning record against the Rainbow Wahine. The other three elite programs, Florida, Nebraska, and Penn State. And that's what made last year's victory over Penn State in the NCAA tournament. So significant for Dave Shoji and this program. But yeah, you're talking about some of the fine teams and institutions in all the land. Step out goes to Castillo here out of the timeout. Back row set. Here's Haggerty. Roll shot is good. Molly Haggerty is good. That is kill number 8 for her on 15 swings. Wow.
Only one error. Nelson also has eight kills. She's got no errors, hitting 727.
Serve goes out, though.
Sounds like a jet airliner for Haley Nelson, her percentage.
Wisconsin hitting 389 for the match, 333 in this set. Hawaii hitting 000 for the entirety of this match. Outside, here's Gillis, big windup, but the block was up. Mags and Higgs saying hop over.
So Hawaii's defense now picking it up to earn a point, but where Hawaii really has to earn some points is, you know, a stepped up offense right now. Hitting 0-0-0 is not going to get it done against any team in the country.
There's Gillis.
The low numbers on offense are understandable given how many adjustments they've had to be made for the players that have been injured. And by the way, none of those injuries were from overtraining or overuse because of, you know, Jeff Hollis' staff being over-eager to get the girls in shape. There was 2 flukes there and a surgery.
It did not prevent some of us, though, wise-cracking media members, to still ask Dave Shoji, see what happens when you leave the program for a few weeks?
There you go.
But no, he had nothing but positive things to say about the rest of that coaching crew that held the fort down while he was in Rio. Outside, here's Krishkova off the block. Good touch there by Kelch to keep it alive. Granato blocked, but she's there to pop it up. A second windup. Again, the same. But Hawaii will maintain control. Here's Kelch from the opposite position. Tried to go hard angle, a little too hard. And it's a point for Wisconsin. The Rainbow Wahine are getting some swings. The defense, the ball control that is a staple of Dave Shoji and his programs, it's there. They're just not cashing in on it. Wisconsin has helped Hawaii with some service errors here throughout the first half of this match. It's a matter of the Rainbow Wahine converting in transition. Here's Maglio. That's an example right there. Fourth kill. 14 attacks for Emily Maglio. Expect that total to rise even more here as we go forward.
Hawaii's side-out percentage in the first set was 56%. In order to win volleyball games at the Division I level against the good teams, you've got to hit around 70% for your side-out percentage.
Anderson with the float serve. Pass Bates. Middle set. And that one is crammed to the floor by Haley Nelson.
Oh, Haley Nelson, so versatile, so agile, so strong.
Here's Maglio. That one misses long. Yeah, Haley Nelson right now, Chris, hitting 692. 9 kills, no errors, 13 attempts. But she is known to be one of the more efficient hitters in the country. In fact, ranks first in program history coming into this season with a 367 career hitting percentage. Krishkova off the block. Right side, Kelch couldn't get a full swing on it, set a little low for her. It misses wide, point for the Badgers.
I'm surprised Higgins didn't go to Maglio there again. Maglio hits for a pretty high percentage there in the middle. Let's see if she goes through here on a good pass.
No, instead goes right side again to Kelch. Handcuffed Nelson, but Wisconsin's able to forge a swing by Haggerty. Hawaii on the return now. Sibley blocked. Maglio on the second touch, nickels it over. Bump set, Krishkova tried to push it deep. Right there was Anderson. Middle set, Maglio blocked, but she pops it up. The second touch swing by Sibley, but a net violation called on the Frosh. And she looks befuddled at the call by Dixon Chung.
Take a look and see if she touches the net. I don't think
think so.
Of course, you hear the reaction of the fans here in the Stan Sheriff Center looking at the big screen above and the replay that just played out. And I think a few of them disagreed, and that was enough to get Dave Shoji to follow through as well. I think he's liking this challenge thing.
May not be challengeable. I guess it is, yes.
So there are specific areas of the game that can be challenged. Obviously, it is in or out calls, touch calls, but also foot fouls and net fouls. And so this falls into the category of a potential net violation or not. It was called a net violation, so that should be remembered.
What happened was the cable, ball hit the cable, and the cable shook as she followed through with her swing. So it looked like she netted, but she really didn't. The net shook because of the ball making contact with the cable right there. But her hand, notice her hand never touches the net. I think the challenge would go in favor of Hawaii.
We'll wait to see the ruling here. And Dixon Chun. And they're going to replay it. So that is another option. It can either be upheld in terms of the call that's being challenged, it can be reversed, or the officiating crew can choose to replay the point. And so that appears to be the decision here by Dixon Chun. What do you think, Chris?
I thought it should have been ruled completely in favor of Hawaii, and the point should have been given to Hawaii, but maybe he thought that he just didn't have any overwhelming evidence that it was not a net.
So they'll do it up all over again. Middle set Mags. Dug up by Nelson. Wow. But she'll have to free ball it over. Chance here for Hawaii. Higgins. Middle set. Maglio. Dug up by Nelson again. And it will be punched over. Maglio a third time. Is able to put it down.
See why I think you should go to Maglio? Every chance you get, just keep feeding her until she gets tired. Till her arm falls off.
That was definitely the thought process there from Taylor Higgins.
At least on the good passes. What's going to happen is they'll pay so much attention to her in the middle, it'll make it easier for the outside hitters to get one-on-one situations.
Well, Tiana Williams getting some attention in the middle. And she made quick work of that set from Carlini. Think about Lauren Carlini, so good at spreading the wealth. They're finding Williams in the middle, but last year there were five hitters for this Wisconsin team that averaged at least 2.2 kills per set.
That sounds like a Carlini-led offense.
Here's Kelsch from the opposite position. Right there is Gillis. High and away, Haggerty, high hands, dug up by Anderson. Played out of the bench area by Kahakai. Sibley the roll shot. We play on. Back row set, Gillis, blocked. Kept alive by McDonald. And a free chance here for Hawaii. Higgins goes outside. Sibley blocked. But right there is Castillo. So right side, it's Kelsch. The block was late, and she took advantage. And she hears it from this crowd.
Appreciative first night crowd. Looks like a, what do you think, 6,000 maybe? 7,000?
I'm never good at this.
Your dad used to pick it by the number, get it on the exact number. Can't you please?
I'm not there yet.
Live up to his.
That's too high of a standard. Here's Sibley off the block and out. So a little bit of something being put together by the Rainbow Wahine.
What's happening right now is the Hawaii's attackers are easing up a little bit in their attacks, not being quite so aggressive, not hitting as many balls out, challenging the block more, and hoping to get coverage or hoping the block will make a mistake. And it seems to be working.
Oh, that serve just getting over the tape. Step out to Williams, and she handcuffs Kahakai in the back row.
Carlini, watch Carlini lean forward and then go backwards at the last second. Arches her back at the last second. Cool Castillo right there.
Served by Haggerty. Step out goes to Castillo, but Bates able to pop it in the air. Here's Gillis through the block, dug up momentarily by Anderson, touched over the net, but wide of the floor by Higgins.
Claire Marie Anderson having some sort of night. 8-9 dig so far.
Timeout, Hawaii. 21-13, Badgers in the second. Welcome back. Let's check out the First Hawaiian Bank top three. Hawaii single match service aces, Amber Kaufman. I remember that one. September 13, 2008, 11 aces versus Washington. That tops the list. Taylor Higgins, though, she's in that number three position. Remember September 4th, 2014 versus New Mexico, 8 service aces. But Hawaii has its work cut out for it here in the season opener against Wisconsin. Some trouble on the service receive there. Chance for the Badgers, Gillis. And she just went up over the block posed by Castillo and Higgins.
Lauren Gillis, a transfer from USC, comes in on the inside set. Little play set there for Gillis. Give her a little different look. USA junior national team. You know what her nickname is? Low, low, low your boat.
Here's Gillis on the outside. Kelch from the back row. Dug up by McDonald. Bates with the bump set to Gillis. She had to play it over her shoulder. Good swing. Carlini on the second touch. But it'll be a back row attacker called against Carlini. So it becomes a Hawaii point. Good idea. The execution, though, not there.
Carlini actually was a front row attacker. What happened was, I believe the libero set the ball in front of the 3-meter line, and you cannot attack that second ball. That's why you see that, you know, the liberos will bump set the ball inside the 3-meter line.
Pass tight to the net, and Castillo again. Some timing issues certainly at what is a new position for her. Going from the outside hitter spot to that middle position, and just a little late on some of these reactions.
Castillo did play some middle when she was in high school and club ball, but not quite the level and speed of Division I ball. She's also played on the right side last year. She played on the left side. This is her third different position.
9 service errors in this match for Wisconsin. I mean, where would we be if not for those? Tori Blake coming into the match, and Castillo with the serve. Haggerty first touch. Step out goes to Blake. And the timing wasn't there. Pumps it long. Wisconsin preseason pick to finish third in the Big Ten behind Nebraska, the defending national champs, and Minnesota in the number 2 spot. Lauren Carlini and Haley Nelson preseason all Big Ten selections. Carlini, interestingly enough, actually played with Nikki Taylor on the U.S. Pan American Cup team that took bronze in the Dominican Republic, and here she is to serve on Aloha Ball here in the second set. Step out, Maglio. Just missed the end line, and that's a point for the Badgers, and that puts an end to set number 2. They go up 2-0 here on opening night against an underhanded Rainbow Wahine squad. And Kelly Sheffield's team will have an opportunity to bust out the Bruins. Welcome back. Let's take a look at the McDonald's match statistics. All Badgers so far tonight, Chris.
See, what really jumps out is the kills. 32-13 for the Badgers. And they hit 324 to Hawaii's negative 013. Oh, not good numbers offensively for Hawaii. At least Hawaii has got 4 blocks to the Badgers' 3. Not enough to get it done, though.
I thought Scott Robbs asked an interesting question of the corner crew during the timeout, and that was, what becomes the objective here for Dave Shoji and this coaching staff? What do they need to see from this Hawaii team here down 2-0?
Well, I agree with Lisa, what Lisa said about serving. I think they need to serve tougher, try to get some aces, try to get Wisconsin out of system. And I think they need to, at the same time, they need to pass better so they can get their offense to run a little bit more smoothly, set the middle more. Get the outside hitters so they get some in-system sets where they're only facing one blocker instead of 2 giant six-footers out there.
And
here's a subbing substitution that may or may not help things.
Maybe to help get that offense running smoother, Dave Shoji going to give Noreen Iosia a try. 5'11", freshman, highly touted recruit from Torrance, California, where she led Redondo Union to four league titles and a pair of state titles, was a state player of the year two times. And there's the step out to Emily Maglio. She's able to dink it in. We are also getting word. In fact, we will see the insertion now of Natasha Burns, redshirt freshman, 6'5", from Canada, Hamilton, Ontario, Canada, to be exact. Did not play last year, had the redshirt because of a broken hand, suffered early in the season.
It has the distinction of being the largest Wahine ever to wear the uniform. At 6'5".
So trying some new faces, and Emily Maglio welcoming Noreen Eosia to the court in a most auspicious way by serving it into the back of her head. She feels pretty bad about it, I'm sure. One serving one. We've seen a little bit of everything here so far from Hawaii. Good swing by Burns, but it's returned. Eosia goes outside. Here's Granado. It's dug up in the back row by Bates. A little dink back and forth. Eosia gets above the net and blocks the effort of Nelson. Noreen Eosia, when you watch her play, the thing that stands out, Chris, the instinct, certainly for the game, and the hands, just soft, feathery hands for Noreen Eosia. Comes through with the service ace as well.
There's the tough serving Lisa Stranma was talking about. And what I agree with, Hawaii does need to serve tougher, get Wisconsin out of system.
Another good serve. Middle set, and that one smashed down by Haley Nelson.
Wisconsin showing their respect for this Rainbow Wahine program, and Dave Shoji going with basically the same lineup despite dominating the first two sets.
And that one drops in for an ace. The judgment not accurate that time by Greeley and Kahakai in the back row. So three serving three. Right side, here's Granado. Block and roof. Molly Haggerty getting a good piece of that one. She has been exceptional in her Wisconsin debut.
She is the real deal. Telling you, four state champions, four-time state champions, four-time national club champion. That's an incredible record.
You'll see a right side, Granado. The block was late there, but still popped it up. So outside it goes to Haggerty. Dug up by Greeley. You'll see it outside to Kelsch. The dink is blocked back. Burns covered it. And a little ping pong match at the net. Won by Hawaii.
Burns might have got that the last touch there.
Well, you can't teach 6'5". And Natasha Burns has that. Four serving four. And it's an overpass. The swing by Kelsch. I'll make that Sibley puts it down. And a timeout by Wisconsin as the Rainbow Wahine take a 5-4 advantage in the third. Welcome back to the Stat Sheriff Center. Wisconsin dominating the first two sets, 25-16 in one and two. But the Rainbow Wahine is showing a little bit of flair here in the third.
Well, here's it. How about these numbers? Wahine 143. No, Wisconsin hitting negative 200. There's a switcheroo.
And McKenna Granado out of Punahou School, now a sophomore with the serve. Pass by Lauren Gillis, right side set. And that is Krishkova. That one goes off of the shoulder area of Granado and out of bounds.
That was a bomb by Krishkova. Four kills, only one error. She's hitting 300. All Nebraska starters, I believe, all hitting over 300. Or Wisconsin, I should say Wisconsin. Well, they're both red.
Yeah. That one worked out in favor of Hawaii on the Kahakai overpass.
Nebraska and Wisconsin actually will be battling out for the Big Ten Championship, as will Minnesota. That quality at the top of that league is so good.
Step out. And that is Tiana Williams getting it turned right back. Return to sender. Says Kirsten Sibley.
They call her Sibs. And she had it all going on that time following the step-out maneuver. Great block.
Seven serving five. Outside set goes to Haggerty, dug up by Kahakai. Yosia goes outside to Sibley. That's dug up by Bates. Wisconsin on the attack. Haggerty, hard angle and in. Not the kind of stuff you usually see from freshmen. But you know, she cut that one hardcore.
She loves you across court. You know, the block keeps moving inside, inside. They're not moving inside enough for her. She just cram it down the 3-foot line, the 10-foot line.
You'll see it from the knees with the set out to Sibley. Now goes backside to Kelsch off the block and down. What do you think of Noreen Yosia?
I'll tell you one thing we've seen is that her hands are really strong. Like on that one bad pass she got, she was about 40 feet away from front left and she just put it on a dime.
Soft serve by Kelsch. Step out. Williams pumps it long. Was there a touch? No touch. Hawaii up three here in the third. This is the largest lead that the Rainbow Wahine have held at any point in this match. And you hear and see some of the efforts off the bench by Lindsey Berg, one of the newcomers to this coaching staff. Outside, and it's Gillis trying to restore Wisconsin order. But Noreen Yosia, Chris, 2016 Andy Collins Award winner, given to the top senior setter in the nation. One of six children, has two sisters and three brothers. And boy, does she have some feathery hands, and sets up her fellow frosh, Sibley, who finds the deep corner.
Sibley goes up high, goes the high hands deep to area five on the court. Not an easy shot to make. So many players are tempted to hit the ball straight down. Sibley, seven kills on the night.
Calais Greeley on to serve. Rainbow Wahine trying to begin to mount a comeback here in this match. Bump set goes to Gillis from off the net. Two-handed in the air by Greeley. High set, Granato off the block. Greeley there has it covered. You'll see a step out to Maggs. High hands. Haggerty there. Step out for Wisconsin goes to Nelson, and she didn't get all of it, but she put it in the right spot.
Well played point that time by Hawaii, especially. They served tough and had Wisconsin on their heels the whole rally, and then a nice little step out maneuver there once again by Haley Nelson.
11 kills now for Nelson. 8 serving 10. You'll see ya. On the short slide to Maglio, and she goes off the block and down. Well, whatever Dave Shoji said to this team in the timeout after set two, during that intermission, he seems to have at least sparked something.
Well, the biggest change, I think, has been the serving has been tougher, which is put Wisconsin on their heels. They're not in system all the time. Hawaii's block can set up better. Defense behind the block is set up better. And of course, you'll see us playing fearlessly as a freshman.
And that one does not get over the net off of the palm of Sarah Dodd. So Hawaii leading here. 12 serving 9. And Noreen Yosia back to serve. Will apply the jump serve. That's a good one. Bates, good pass though. Outside Haggerty with no blockers up. And she missed an opportunity as she sends it wide.
A rare error from Haggerty. Only her second of the night.
Yosia comes with it again. The crowd loves the serves. Right side. Kruskova denied. Natasha Burns, welcome to the staff chair of center floor.
Natasha Burns at 6'5", loving her first block right there.
Now that one curled a little too much for Eosia, but Hawaii with a 4-point advantage here, the midway point of this third set. Middle set, here's Burns, didn't get a full swing on it. Outside, Haggerty off the high hands, right there's Kahakai. Eosia sets up Kelch against the double block, rejected. Tiana Williams got the gist of that one. She was fourth in the Big Ten Conference last year in blocks per set, had five or more blocks in 19 matches. So that was certainly in her wheelhouse right there. Bernardo had to take on the second touch. Now a free chance here for the Badgers. Middle set, Williams, great dig by Greeley. Here's Kelsch against the double block, but she went into the antenna. And another point for the Badgers. Well, what are you fighting, Chris? But can they muster up enough against this extremely talented Wisconsin squad? Down two sets to none here in the third.
Kendra Kelsch asked to hit an awful lot of balls. She's been a center exclusively for the last couple of years. All of a sudden now she's hitting a ton of balls.
You'll see her going out to Kelsch. Dug up. But a free ball coming here for Hawaii. Kahakai the pass. You'll see her the set. Middle to Burns. What a one-handed great save by Gillis. Kuzmikova's dug up. Granado the dink.
First kill for McKenna Granado tonight. Taking a while to get going, but couldn't come at a better time to give Hawaii a 15-12 lead here in the third set, down two sets to none. The last run Hawaii had, by the way, is the first time Hawaii has scored 3 points in a row tonight.
15 serving 12, and those are the kinds of plays that'll kill you if you're trying to come from behind.
I'll tell you, that's what's going to happen, though, if the staff is asking to serve tougher. Or maybe they heard Lisa Strand in the intermission.
Yeah, maybe.
Hey, serve tougher and good things will happen. You're going to have a miss once in a while when you get that aggressive.
Didn't work out for Hawaii there. 13 serving 15. Served by Amber McDonald. Good first touch. Granado. Burns in the middle. And Natasha Burns with her first career kill.
What was great about that was Burns was ready. Ilsea was going to set a ball, but nobody thinks it's going to be set to the middle. She goes to Burns anyway and surprises the Wisconsin block, actually.
Outside, here's Haggerty off the block and down. Haggerty has been a one-person wrecking crew here for Wisconsin. That's kill number 10 by Arkham.
A large reason why Wisconsin was had the number 13 recruiting class here this year in the country.
Granado off the tape. Here's Gillis, big windup, and then she just rolled it down the line right in front of Eosia. Dave Shoji calls for a timeout. His Rainbow Wahine squad in position to stay alive in this match. Welcome back. Let's check out how it works, presented by Central Pacific Bank. Chris, take us through it.
You want to see how it works to give your hitters one-on-one attacks? Where you see Burns putting it down there. When Eosia is not supposed to set the middle, she does. She's about the 8-foot line, but she should have gone to one of the pins. Instead, she went to the middle and surprised Wisconsin block.
That time she went to the pin on the outside, and Kirsten Sibley delivers again. She has a team high 8 kills by our count. Sibley has also gotten a considerable amount of work up in the 26 attempt range here in her debut. Welcome to the show.
That's way more than she thought she'd ever have. She thought maybe she'll get in maybe mid-season. Instead, night one, up against the number 4 team in the country.
Beautiful dig there by Kahakai. Guinasso the bump set to Sibley block. Maglio keeps it alive. Joust at the net. You'll see it pops it in the air. Bump set Sibley from off the net. Chance now for the Badgers. They go outside. It's Gillis over the double block. One hand save. Kahakai, but a net violation against Mags is called as she was scrambling for that second touch. Savannah Kahakai comes into this season, Chris, her junior year out of Barrington High School, with the reputation now of being among the best liberos in the country. Step out. Maglio didn't get a full swing on it. Here's Gillis. She does get a full swing on it. Guinasso digs it over the net, and Gillis gobbles it up.
After that comment about Kahakai, I can attest to the fact that she is not only one of the best liberos in the country, she's among the hardest working as well. Every day I went to practice these last 2 weeks, she's there in the beginning getting extra reps, and she stays afterward an extra half hour getting more reps.
Gillis off the block. Kahakai there to clean it up. Back row set to Granato. Great dig by McDonald in the back row for Wisconsin. Now Gillis getting plenty of work on that outside pin. Again dug up by Kahakai. Sibley. Diving save Bates. Gillis a third time dug up over the net by Guinasso. Yet another lengthy rally here in this match. Kahakai sets up Sibley off the block. Scramble play. Hawaii with it again. Eosia, the dump shot.
That came out of nowhere. Did you expect that? Wow.
Noreen Eosia, the Frosh, catching the whole building off guard on that one.
Crafty little side set here. No one saw that coming.
On a gold medal representing American Samoa at the 2015 Pacific Games in Papua New Guinea. She is an experienced player, even in the international realm of the game, as Gillis just continues to vacuum up sets. That time puts it down. That is her ninth kill on 29 attempts.
Gillis described herself in the media guide program. She described herself with one word: hard working. And certainly she's getting the job done tonight.
Keeps answering the bell. The serve by Carlini. Bump set. Here's Granato. Off the block. Kept alive by Haggerty. Gillis again. Guinasso there. Joust at the net. Another joust. Eosia wins this one.
Nelson gets the last push, even though she's going up against a bigger player. She manages to get that last push in and get the point.
Making quite a first impression.
Lindsay Berg, the setting coach for Hawaii, working hard on the bench.
Gillis on the delay middle, and she slams it home, getting back to Lindsay Berg. Three-time Olympian, two-time silver medalist, Chris, and by all accounts, she has been pretty firm with the setters. She is a coach who is demanding. This whole college coaching thing, a little new for her, right? And so there's been an adjustment there, but it seems to have been received in a positive way by this Rainbow Wahine squad.
How can they not listen to someone who is a three-time Olympian?
Granato had some pepper on that one, but a good dig by Bates. A free ball coming here for the Wahine. Eosia goes outside. Granato a little tight to the pin. So scramble play here for the Badgers. Haggerty the swing. It may have been an out ball. Guinasso got the last touch on it. Third lead change of this third stanza. Hawaii so close to extending this match, which unto itself would be an extremely incredible accomplishment.
Each team with one timeout left here.
And that is service error number 11 here tonight for the Badgers. So Noreen Eosia, freshman from Torrance, California, will serve. We are knotted at 20. Hawaii trailing two sets to none. Outside, it goes to Haggerty, pounds it down, but it misses wide, and Hawaii takes a step in front.
You can tell she's a little uncomfortable going down the line. 90% of her shots tonight have been cross-court. I don't think if she gets the next one, it's definitely going cross court. Her safer shot.
Great serve. Pass tight to the net. Outside Haggerty. There it is.
It was her cross court go-to shot. What a save by Carlini on that tight pass to the net.
Lauren Carlini has been all she's cracked up to be here tonight. Hawaii knotted with Wisconsin in set three. Burns hit it into the twine. But some valuable experience points being granted to some of these young Rainbow Wahine players. Well, they're going to look to try to extend this match, trailing Wisconsin now. 22 serving 21. Right side, here's Granato. Double block up. Burns tried to put it down. It's rattled around, and it goes out. Point for the Rainbow Wahine.
Burns at 6'5", those long arms. She's tapping the ball down, almost 50-50 ball. She has no problem at all. Barely jumping and hitting those down.
How about this lineup, Chris? You have the sophomore Granato serving and three freshmen on the floor in Sibley, Burns, and Eosia. Outside, Haggerty. Oh, that one stuck through the block proposed by Burns.
If there's a better freshman in the Big Ten this year, I'd like to see who they are. Haggerty's just putting on a show.
Kills on 29 swings for Haggerty, hitting 345. Backside set. Kelsch dug up nicely by Gillis. Haggerty again. Right there is Kahakai. You'll see it. Tracks down the bump set to Sibley by the double block. And done.
You got that youthful exuberance going on right now. Burns, Sibley, you'll see it. Oh, I'm so happy to be out here playing in front of all these fans. Nice little tap down shot by Sibley. Good control that time.
Gritty effort from this youth movement for the Rainbow Wahine. Here's Kelsch. The block was late, but a great dig by Bates. Haggerty off the fingertips right there is Kahakai. You'll see it goes middle to Moglio.
Wisconsin definitely seeing a different kind of offense being set by Eosia, and they have not quite adjusted to it. Some great digging in the back, though, by Bates to keep rallies alive.
And can you believe it? It's Aloha ball for Hawaii in the third. Step out, Williams. Not anymore. Tiana Williams sits him down for the moment. If you're just joining us, short-handed Rainbow Wahine team with injuries to key players, losing the first two sets, 25-16 each, mounting a rally here in the third behind several freshmen who have contributed in this stanza.
What court presence and volleyball IQ by Savannah Kahakai to have the sense to let that last ball drop. She's taking a big chance there, but she made the right call. Another set point.
Aloha ball once again. Gillis comes flying in. Right there is Kahakai. Eosia to Sibley. Even Dave Shoji has to break a smile. What an effort by the youngsters for the Rainbow Wahine. We will play a fourth here at the Stan Sheriff Center. Welcome back to the Stan Sheriff Center. No Nikki Taylor, no Annie Mitchum, a less than 100% Kalei Greeley. Hawaii getting waxed in the first two sets tonight against fourth-ranked Wisconsin in the season opener for both teams, and yet with, at times, three freshmen on the floor in that third set, they extend this match. And even Dave Shoji, who certainly wasn't smiling through the first two sets, even he was pretty excited about that one.
That smile is, oh boy, did we get away with one there. How about that?
And we talk about the chess match that goes on between these coaches and the puzzle pieces that had to be rearranged here this week by Dave Shoji, who has already played 16 players in this match. Wisconsin, by the way, has played 14, just to give you an idea. But Noreen Eosia, in particular, coming in at the center spot, the freshman from Torrance, California. And Chris, she made quite a statement and a great first impression, certainly, here to the fans at the Stan Sheriff Center.
Enough to earn another starting spot here in September 4. On the pregame show, it was notified that Marina Garcia has got, Lindsey Berg was saying that she's got some decent leadership skills for a freshman. Certainly there you saw her barking some signals, be aggressive on the block. I love your serve. She's got a lot of juice on her serve, wins the battles at the net. As Jeff Hall said, she's got so many awards. She's got all everything, all CIF, you know, all Pacific Games, all American.
9 assists in that third set for Eosia. A service ace, a dig, a block. Was also in on 2 kills because of those dump shots. Here's Gillis as we get started here in set number 4, bump set. Out to Granado, and Wisconsin had that one blanketed. Haley Nelson smothering the swing.
Looks like Casey Castillo is moving out of the middle. She's going to play on the right side. And Burns is going to play in the middle.
So yet another tweak to the lineup here by Dave Shoji. It'll be Sibley from the back row. That's dug up by Carlini. So the bump set goes out to Gillis. And right there is Kahakai. Eosia trying to set up Castillo. Just got it over. Carlini goes middle set. Nice dig there by Kahakai. Scramble play, and Castillo, not really in rhythm, sends it wide of the floor. Casey Castillo, 6'3 sophomore from Oceanside, California, appeared in 19 matches last season. Played sparingly for sure. Suffered a left ACL tear in high school, and that sort of changed the course of things a little bit for her. And she continues to search for a true niche here on this Rainbow Wahine squad. Of course, that search shortened a little bit based on the injuries and some of the circumstances surrounding her as that one goes long. And it is another point for Wisconsin, jumping out to a 3-0 lead here in the fourth.
And not easy to go from playing middle all during fall camp, all of a sudden now being put back in your old position on the outside, but still doing the best job she can. Nice high snapper there for the kill.
Yeah, that the ring is certainly there for sure. You see what she is capable of in system. So one serving 3, and McKenna Granado will serve it into play. Gillis with the first touch. Middle set, and the roof is up. Natasha Burns telling Haley Nelson, oh, no, you don't.
Well, Haley Nelson does not get blocked very often. She's got the all-time kill percentage record for Wisconsin at 367.
Sarah Dodd to serve for the Badgers. 4 serving 2. Passed by Sibley. She'll get the set on the outside. The block was late. Great effort by Carlini, but he comes up empty on the dive. And it's a point for Hawaii, and another kill for Kirsten Sibley.
I was most impressed with Sibley's pass that time, even more so than the attack. She took a tough serve and passed it right to the money, right on the money to Noreen Eosia.
These freshmen, they are blossoming before our eyes here in this season opener. Crowd quiets. Kahakai taking her time, sending it down the line. Outside it goes. There's Haggerty. Again, 14th kill for her on her 32nd swing.
I think she definitely saw the block drift inside.
So she said, okay, if you're going to take away my favorite shot, I'll take my second favorite shot.
It may have been an out ball, but fielded by Granado. Sibley from off the net, diving save, Gillis. Oh, and falling to the floor is Romana Krishkova. Not sure exactly what happened there, but Kelly Sheffield up off the bench to make sure that this senior opposite is okay.
Well, ironically, in the media guide, one of the things she said she likes chocolate. She started volleyball when she was 10, and she likes to play on any surface that's Terraflex.
Well, wish granted, but Terraflex biting her back on that particular.
I don't remember any wet spots over there, but she's playing on the surface she likes, that's for sure.
She appears to be okay, so a huge sigh of relief from Badger Nation here at Stan Sheriff Center. Four serving five, and Emma Smith on the serve. That's a good one. That's going to be a joust at the net. Pinballed around on the Wisconsin side. Free ball coming for Hawaii, a chance to tie this one up. Step out, Maglio. And we're knotted at five.
Of all people, I think Carlini took an out ball there. She probably thought it was a touch on the block.
Ball, I think, should have been out, should have been a point for Hawaii right there. Great serve by Emma Smith to cause that. And then here's the end of the play. Well, the end of the play was Maglio with the kill.
Oh, that one just trickling over. Bump set, Haggerty hits the antenna, and Hawaii vaults ahead. Chris, if you're Wisconsin, and things were like clockwork for you in the first two sets, certainly through the perspective of Kelly Sheffield, what is going through the Badgers' mind right now?
Well, I think the first thing is he's got to be wondering is, well, we were sided out at 93% the first set, 75% the second set, and it got even lower in the third set, sided out at 63%. He's got to be a little concerned about his offense, I would think. Although for the match, they're hitting 296, a very, very good number.
Williams with her ninth kill. She's one away from double digits. That would give Wisconsin four players with double-digit kills in this match. Step out, Maglio blocked. Nice job by Williams. Kept alive, though, by Smith. The dink shot by Sibley. And it's going to be a free ball coming for Hawaii. Another chance to take the lead. You'll see it out to Sibley off the block. Played off the net there by Williams. Bump set. Haggerty will get a good swing on it. But it is turned back by Emily Maglio.
This is just a well-formed block. Maglio knows it's going there, so there's two people up right away. Maglio pressing over the net and down, and there's her celebration. Both arms raised up in a V fashion almost of victory. Great block.
Here's the serve by Greeley. Step out Williams, and she's able to find the seam. We're knotted at seven. But this has to be a little unnerving from the Badgers' standpoint. Things were flowing so smoothly through the first two sets. Now all of a sudden, some lineup changes. You have this youth movement out there on the floor for Hawaii, and Wisconsin having a bit of an issue trying to ultimately solve that. Maglio against a triple block. Scramble play. Haggerty from the back row. Diving save, Greeley. That was splendid. Here's Granado. Off the touch and down.
If I'm Coach Sheffield, I'm worried a little bit. I'm not going to push any panic buttons because his team is so veteran. They're so used to playing with each other. He's got his freshman Haggerty playing out of her mind. So I wouldn't be all that worried.
A one-handed set by Carlini following a brilliant serve by Maglio, and Burns in the middle.
Natasha Burns. 6'5 freshman from Hamilton, Ontario, Canada. Coming at you with all arms and legs and braided hair and just getting the job done right now.
And this crowd is appreciative of this Rainbow Wahine effort to try to hang with Wisconsin after trailing two sets to none. Still a long way to go, obviously, but leading by two here in the fourth. Maglio, the jump serve. Set outside to Gillis, the dink shot, and it works. Pulled the string at just the right time. That is now 11 kills for Gillis on 35 attempts. I mean, gaudy, gaudy numbers here for the primary offensive hitters. Joust at the net. And guess who wins it? Maureen Eocia.
Eocia 2 on Joust. Wisconsin 0.
And this was against a pair of Badgers. There are just some players who have that knack, that natural instinct, and Eocia appears to be that brand of player.
Also, she takes that deep breath before she does her jump serve as part of her pre-jump serve routine, and just rips his serve.
The dink shot by Nelson, and it falls in between a couple of Wahine.
Nelson, known as a teen comedian for Wisconsin. Nothing funny about that for Hawaii, though. Great tip shot.
Nelson with the last laugh there. Here's the running serve by Carlini. Middle set Burns. Kind of paintbrushed it. Diving save on the second touch by Carlini. Chance here for Hawaii. Right side. Granado. Blocked back, kept alive, though, by Kahakai, and a free ball sent Wisconsin's way. Carlini picks and chooses. The step out is blocked by Burns. It's going to be a point for the Rainbow Wahine.
Sibley back in the front row. A sophomore, a redshirt freshman, and a true freshman in the front row right now. Do they get any younger? Would Dick Vitale call these the diaper bandits?
Oh, yes.
Or what?
Yes.
I think they would qualify, wouldn't they?
Absolutely. I mean,
and in the back row, they've got a true freshman, Eocia. They've got Granado, the sophomore, and Kyle Kai, the mama of the team, as a junior.
The elder statesman out there. 11 serving 9. Granado floats it deep. Bump set. The swing by Krishkova. That was nicely done.
I think the biggest difference in the third and fourth sets has been Hawaii's wrapped up their serving aggressiveness. It's forced a lot of out-of-system sets. It's a great shot by Krishkova. Just hits it between the two blockers.
10 serving 11. Here's Dodd. Tries to attack the freshman, Sibley. Good pass there. She'll get the set on the outside. The block wasn't ready, and she eats it up.
And again, they're trying to pick on the freshman, Sibley. She passed that on a dime. She rewarded with the set back and just rips it down the line.
11 kills for Sibley to lead the Rainbow Wahine, the only player in double digits in kills.
Sibs, after a slow start, now hitting 194.
Oh, Haggerty, look out.
You know, the ball just sounds differently when she hits it, doesn't she? Just kaboom. Just a powerful swing. Block not quite closing there.
What a find for Kelly Sheffield. Molly Haggerty has a brother and two sisters. Both sisters playing college volleyball as well. Krishkova against a double block. Dug up by Kahaka. So Eocia goes to Sibley. Tried to go hard angle, a little too hard. She cut it out of bounds. But Molly Haggerty, her sister Megan played volleyball at Nebraska. Her sister Maddie is a redshirt sophomore outside hitter at Michigan State. So a Big Ten volleyball family as Nelson sends it into the twine. See Kelly Sheffield in his fourth season, 16th overall as a head coach. Also coached at Dayton and Albany. In fact, overall, he has taken his teams to 11 NCAA tournaments in 15 seasons of head coaching.
2013 Volleyball Monthly Coach of the Year.
Haggerty, the block was late. Great job by Kahakai. Sibley from off the net, couldn't curl it in.
And never played competitive volleyball.
That's right. In fact, his first match as a coach at the collegiate level was in Hawaii, in the Stan Sheriff Center in 1997 as an assistant for Houston. And he said he immediately fell in love with college volleyball because he saw with his own eyes what it could be in front of a crowd like what we have traditionally here at the Stan Sheriff Center. Here's Sibley, winds up, uncoils, and unleashes off the block.
Say, one thing about Kirsten Sibley is I watched her over the last 2 weeks in fall camp. The hardest thing for her is putting together back-to-back-to-back great swings. And little by little, during this match, she's getting better at putting together strings of great shots.
Kirsten Sibley winning the ice pack challenge so far. 39 swings for her.
There's a pass that's off the net. Once again, out of system.
And Haggerty, that was her 39th attempt. Missed wide. And Hawaii up two. First to 15. What are we watching here? Welcome back. Not only is it opening night here at the Stan Sheriff Center for the Rainbow Wahine Volleyball Team, but the Rainbow Warrior Football Team in the Sydney Bowl down under in Australia. Falling to Cal 51-31, but for Hawaii, there were some points of encouragement here in the opener in the Nick Rolovich era. The most points and yards recorded in the last 14 FBS games for Hawaii, and three running backs scored for the Rainbow Warriors. So perhaps a foundation to build off of despite the 20-point loss. We return to live action here, and it's McKenna Granado off the block and down.
Thanks to the 21st dig of the night by Savannah Kahakai. She's really starting to figure out the Wisconsin attackers. 21.
That's incredible.
Digs.
Kelly Bates has been pretty good on the other side for Wisconsin as well. She's got 18 digs. But Kahakai has done some where the degree of difficulty has been sky high. Greeley into the net it goes. Kalei Greeley will be an interesting story to follow as she continues to come back from that shoulder surgery. She's about nine months post-op. So it'll be interesting to see how she's able to strengthen that shoulder here over the course of the season. Outside, here's Granado. That shoulder looks pretty strong. Plows it through that double block.
It's reminiscent of how Granado played against Iowa State during the spring game. He's powering the ball through blocks, around blocks, even sometimes over blocks.
Well, how about she saved her best for last, a career-high 385 hitting percentage against Minnesota in the NCAA regional final last year. Eosia out to Granado, the dink, snipped out by McDonald. Outside, Gillis had to readjust the jump. Advantage Hawaii. Eosia out to Granado. Two-handed in the air by Haggerty. Gillis the swing. Greeley had a touch on it, but it falls to the floor for a Wisconsin point. I mean, this is starting to turn into something amazing here. Just the fact that we've gotten to this point, Hawaii falling in the first two sets to Wisconsin. Again, we cannot reiterate enough, no Nikki Taylor, no Annie Mitchum, a less than 100% Kalei Greeley. They fall 25-16 in the first set, 25-16 in the second set, and turn things around in the third with, at times, three freshmen on the floor. And there's another freshman for Hawaii making a play here. In this fourth set, Natasha Burns getting another kill. And her confidence meter continues to get throttled up with every play. Hawaii taking the third set. And here now leading in the fourth, trying to extend this to a decisive fifth set. And a nice play by Lauren Carlini to get the point for Wisconsin.
That was a big-time play. It was a sure point for Hawaii. Could have been a joust. Could have been a neck. Could have been a lot of things. But Carlini's such the veteran. She just taps it deep to the corner. Area five, wide open.
A serve by Carlini. You'll see it goes backside. Granado two hands it deep corner. Carlini pops it in the air. Krishkova couldn't get a full swing on it. So Savannah Kahakai will set up Granado through the block. Right there is Haggerty. Outside, Gillis, big swing, block, then roof! McKenna Granado!
Lauren Gillis has not been stopped many times tonight, but she was there. She's been so effective shredding that Hawaii defense, but that time, Granado getting up high, getting up down.
And a timeout called by Wisconsin. Hawaii closing in on a fifth. Looky here, Hawaii dropping the first two sets. We are now in the fourth after winning the third 26-24. The Rainbow Wahine lead by three. What's the difference? What happened after set two, Chris?
Well, their serving's been much more aggressive, number one. And their offense is much better. They're sighting out at 81% as opposed to 46% in the second set.
Kryshkova, that was a blasty blast. Wisconsin back to within two.
And Hawaii's got Marina Yosir taking some more chances at the setting position. You know, setting the middle when she's not supposed to from the 8 or 9 foot line. And just taking some different chances there to spread out the Wisconsin block.
A little less predictability, you were saying.
Exactly.
The way she's setting, it's almost like it's a completely different offense. Sibley, the dink into the deep corner. Outside, here's Haggerty. It's Groundhog Day for Molly Haggerty. 16th kill, 42nd attempt. And Dave Shoji now signals for a timeout. We'll keep it right here at the stand. Sheriff Center, take another look at Haggerty's heroics.
Well, first of all, look at the set by Carlini. It was just on the money from one sideline to the other. Not easy to do. And with no spin on it, by the way. It was Nectar set. Had Hit Me written all over it. And Haggerty finishes as only she's been able to do.
Reminder to stick around for the Heineken postgame show coming up right after the match as our side set crew, the corner crew, breaks down all of tonight's highlights and stats. And one of the members of the corner crew, let's go to him now, in fact, to jump in. Ryan Kalesuji, what's up?
Hey, thanks, Connell. Well, right now, assistant coach Lindsey Berg really taking control of this team on the huddle, talking to the team about siding out. Lindsey Berg, we talked to her earlier this week, and she said the one thing that she's trying to instill in these players is simply passion. She said some of the players lack it, and with it, it can take their game to a whole nother level. She's trying to get her team to really focus on siding out and getting into an offensive rhythm. Right now, she's talking specifically with Noreen Iosia, and trying to get this team to side out more efficiently. Back to you.
Thanks a lot, Ryan. It's interesting just watching Lindsey Berg operate on that bench. She is very active, up and off the bench at a high frequency. She's shouting instructions, words of encouragement. What do you see in Lindsey Berg as a coach?
Well, I think Dave Shoji's been great about giving her some reins, letting her go, letting her coach the setters and design an offense that works. And I think that's been, credit to Dave for giving Lindsey that looser rein. Now, Lindsey's no rookie when it comes to coaching, by the way. She does a lot of clinics around the country.
Yeah.
She coached with her sister back at Dartmouth last year. So she knows her way around the coaching world. Dad Dennis was a great coach.
There's Kirsten Sibley. That's dug up by Bates. Outside Haggerty off the block and down, and we are tied at 19.
Sister Erin, by the way, at Dartmouth, now in Illinois, also a really, really good coach. So it kind of runs in the blood.
Yeah.
It's not something new to her, but clearly her three-time Olympic background gets her a lot of attention, a lot of credibility, and the girls listen.
And also played her college ball at Minnesota in the Big Ten, so a lot of experience to extract from here in this particular matchup as that serve goes out. And if there has been a bugaboo for Wisconsin in this match, it has been the out serve, 14 of them.
That's got to bother Coach Sheffield a bit, but I don't think it's the main reason why they fall. It's more Hawaii's playing better.
Middle set, the dink by Nelson. Kept alive by Hawaii and sent back over. Here's Nelson. That one will not be returned. And in fact, immediately, Kelly Sheffield looked to his assistants, and I think there was a very quick debate about whether they were going to challenge that scoop up. But then it didn't matter.
I thought the ball was down, but we'll take a look. Well, maybe she did get it. This angle is probably a little bit better. Maybe she didn't get it. That angle looks like no.
Yeah.
You know what, right now, it doesn't matter.
Yeah, it's a moot point.
Won the rally.
That's right. We are tied at 20. Just the fact that Hawaii has gotten to this point is something of note. Middle set, Maglio off the block, kept alive by Nelson. And that's Tiana Williams. as the momentum continues to swing back towards the Wisconsin Badgers. A 5-1 Badger run has put them up by one.
And Shoji's got one timeout left. Kelly Sheffield's also got one timeout left.
Spirited effort from these proud Rainbow Wahine. Can they extend it to a fifth? The serve by Nelson. Eosia goes outside to Sibley against the double block. And the roof was up. Tiana Williams, one of the very best in that department, able to put Wisconsin up by two.
The pass was such that it demanded the ball go to the pins. The middle blocker, Tiana Williams, was there waiting, ready for Sibley's best shot. So, again, what you see there, you see Lindsay working the huddle, especially talking to Eosia right there.
So we've talked a little bit about what Lindsay Berg has brought to the table. Another newcomer, of course. No newcomer to the game or to coaching, Tom Pestalozzi.
Tom's addition has been a welcome addition, to say the least. There you see him there. He does, first of all, he sent a lot of players to Hawaii, not the last of which was the two-time national JC Player of the Year, Andy Mitchum.
Yeah.
I think Andy's probably happy that he's here for her senior year. But Tom, really wise in his old age. He's got gray hair now. I remember him being...
oh, boy.
You know, but those are gray hairs of wisdom, I think. He brings something special to the table every day. He's much more calm than Lindsay. But they each bring something special to the table each and every day.
Jeff Hall talking about that being part of the experience. Certainly the absence of Dave Shoji is always going to be felt in large part. But he said, you know, the training camp process wasn't just trying to get the players prepared and ready to play this season, but it was for us as coaches, relatively new to one another in the coaching setting, to familiarize ourselves with each other so that when this guy, Dave Shoji, in his 42nd year as head coach comes back, we would have that foundation already set.
Yeah, I'll tell you that coaching office every day is going to be full of idea exchanges as the team goes through the season. There you go. There's a ball down. Great save by Eosia that time on a pass that was almost over the net.
Marini Eosia goes one-hand style to set up Meggs. And Hawaii within a digit.
Intercepts the ball from going over the net. Takes the middle blocker with her.
That's a big-time play.
Magno with a one-on-nine.
A little scramble by the Badgers. Chance here for Hawaii. Anderson the pass. Middle set. Maglio gets it through. Point for Hawaii, and we're knotted again. The eighth tie of this fourth set.
You can expect Maglio is going to see balls in transition like that. Any kind of free ball or down ball, or ball's going to be passed up to the net. I think Marini Eosia will find some way to get the ball to Maglio. I think next time it's going to be on a step out, not on a quick set in front of her.
Kelch to serve. Got to get these in. Outside set, Haggerty off the hands and down. That was her 44th swing of the evening, Chris. Kill number 18.
Now hitting 273. Not a bad number for an outside hitter and a freshman for her first night out.
And a double-double with her 16 digs.
He's a player. He's a player.
Unbelievable. 23 serving 22. Sibley blocked and roofed. And it is Aloha ball for Wisconsin here in the fourth.
The serve by Amber McDonald was very difficult to handle. They should just kind of slow it down by getting Emma Smith in now, just to make a sub to show McDonald a different serve reception group.
Wisconsin for the match. Pass Anderson. Eosia goes step out. Maglio gets the point for Hawaii, and it's not KO yet.
I told you the next move would be a step-out move, and that was it right there on a good pass. You'll see it's going to find her on the antenna, and that's exactly what happened. Now we'll see if the lineup up front here. Carlini's looking at who does she have up front. Guess what? She's got Haggerty up front. And my guess is that she's going to go to Haggerty on a good pass. Maybe Turner Williams on a step-out move, but look for the ball probably to go to Haggerty.
Serve got to get in.
Too easy.
Step-out. Williams blocked. Bump set to Haggerty. She'll get a swing. She's blocked. Carlini sends it over. Diving save. Kahakai. Free ball coming here for Wisconsin. Carlini, step out. Williams, and this one is done. That was a smash by Tiana Williams to end things, but a valiant effort by the Rainbow Wahine. And you have to believe, despite the first set victory, that Kelly Sheffield, the head coach for the Wisconsin Badgers, is breathing a sigh of relief that this one is finally in the books.
Absolutely. He was facing across the net a team that was on fire, finally finding themselves. They had this youthful exuberance going on, and the passion that Lindsey Bird wants to see out there, it was happening on every single point. Hawaii playing so hard.
Scott Ralph is with Dave Choji. Scott, take it away.
All right, thanks a lot, guys. Well, Coach, considering what you had available tonight, and maybe more importantly, what you didn't have available tonight, you got to be really proud.
Well, we just didn't have a lot of firepower in the first two games, and, you know, Sibley really played well, I thought, gave us a lot of offense at the end. You know, Granado struggled, but, yeah, of course we miss Annie and Nikki, but I like the way our kids battled, and Noreen gave us a lift in game three and game four, so... I mean, we've got something to look forward to.
Yeah, I think everybody got kind of excited watching Noreen play out there in the last two sets. Controversy, maybe? Will she get the start tomorrow night?
Well, I don't think so. I think Taylor played pretty well. We just, it wasn't really her fault. We just couldn't get on track there and get any offense. So I'm thinking that Taylor's going to get another shot. And you know, she's a good player. And I thought she played well tonight. Noreen, obviously, is a good player, too. So we'll just have to see how the match evolves.
Talk about how difficult it's been putting together this lineup for this weekend.
Well, we had some issues in game one and two. We just thought we had them ironed out. It just didn't work out. It wasn't real crisp. And so we went back to the traditional way. We thought Maglio would give us a little more out of the back row, but that didn't happen. So we went back to something everybody's familiar with, and it worked better.
All right, Dave, thanks a lot.
All right, Scott.
Guys, back over to you.
Thanks a lot, Scott. What looked like a lost cause after two sets turned into cause for encouragement, perhaps, for these Rainbow Wahine. Molly Haggerty getting the nod for Wisconsin as we bring you the Bank of Hawaii players of the match. 18 kills on about 1,000 swings. Noreen Iosia, who came in the third. You see the numbers there, an all-around game, and certainly some of that intangible leadership that Lindsey Berg was describing when talking about Noreen Iosia, the true freshman out of Torrance, California. So, Chris, night one, how do we summarize what we just saw?
Well, I think that we saw a tale of two cities, basically. We got, you know, the first couple of sets, Hawaii really struggling to get any kind of offense going at all. And the next two sets, serving much, much better, putting Wisconsin out of system a lot and playing much better offense, really turn it around offensively by going back to a traditional lineup and not having quite so many subs running in and out. Dave, the show you described it perfectly. I think it was just much more comfortable for all the players to be in a more traditional system. We'll see what happens tomorrow night when they have the option to do that all over again, or it sounds like he's going to go back with Taylor Higgins.
Yeah.
I don't mind a split night for the two setters. I think the battle should go on, and maybe it'll go on tomorrow night again.
That says something, if we're even referring to it as a battle. Noreen Iosia making quite a first impression here on night one. Hawaii able to hang in there, put a gritty, character-ridden performance together here on night one at the Stan Sheriff Center. It will continue with the Chevron Rainbow Wahine Invitational tomorrow night against Kansas State, and we will bring you that, of course, here on OC Sports. Wisconsin wins it in four to start off 2016 in victorious fashion. Hawaii looking to bounce back on night two of this early season tournament. Stay tuned for the Heineken post-game show. For Chris McLaughlin, I'm Kanoa Leahy. Until tomorrow, aloha.